thank you so much for coming to worship with us, to fellowship with us. And we pray that whatever you come in here with, we pray that God will meet your needs on this morning. We pray that God will meet your needs. If you came in heavy, we pray that you will not leave out heavy. Hallelujah. We thank you, God. Come on, stand to your feet. This is what we consider praise and worship. This is the hour that we begin to worship God and thank him for his goodness and thank him for his mercy, because he's brought us through some things that people don't even know we've been through. He's brought us through those things. He's brought us through some hard times. He's brought us through some sicknesses. He's brought us through some hard times. We experienced some things that were heavy, that were designed to almost take us out. But God, the mercy of God, the
somebody
sovereignty
lift your hand.
Of God, is still keeping us.
As we celebrate the greatness of our God.
We're still pressing our way. We could have gave up and threw in the towel, but we
he's
did
great
not.
And he's greatly to be praised.
So seek God on this morning. If you want to lay at his feet, lay at his feet. Whatever it is that you need from God, seek God on this morning.
This is the worship song that says this, our God is awesome.
Family Church, and Lord, if you have not greeted everybody, go and greet somebody this morning. Go and welcome them.
Keep me in the valley.
Tell them that they are loved.
Hide me from the rain.
Tell them that we appreciate that they came to spend time with us.
Come on,
this
our God
morning.
Is awesome.
Come on, our God
he
is so
heals
awesome.
Me when I'm broken.
What has he done for you?
Give strength where
if
I've been
you take
weak.
A glimpse of your life and you see all the things
rain.
That God has brought you through.
Come on,
this
say
trial,
my God is
this
awesome.
Test right here is no different.
He can
he's
going to
see you through the rest of it. So no matter how
keep
hard your trials
valley.
Are, keep seeking God. God just want to praise from us. He just want us to
my
praise
God
him through the storm. Because when we praise him through
he
the storm,
when I'm
we acknowledge that we know he's working it out for
strength
us.
Where I've been weak.
So God, we thank you.
Forever here
we all
rain.
Have a weak moment. We all
come
have a low moment.
Lift your voice and say,
so God said, get back up and praise him. Because our God
come
is
on,
too
if you
awesome.
Know he's awesome, say it.
We serve an almighty, all-powerful
come on, lift your voice.
God. And will not do for his children. We just have to learn to trust him.
Come on and testify.
And sometimes
awesome.
We don't trust him. We doubt him.
If you
we
believe
start complaining
say,
about it. We start talking to other people
come on
about
and say it.
And we get all confused.
My God.
God said, but if you stay in my
think about
presence,
it. Savior of the whole world.
I will speak. And I will give you clarity.
Giver of salvation.
I will walk you through that thing.
By his stripes.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm healed.
By the stripes of Jesus,
my God
we are
is awesome.
Healed. So for those that are
today
going through
I am
their
forgiven.
Bodies, any type of sickness, just know
his
that
grace
by the
is
stripes
why I'm
of
living.
Jesus, you are healed.
Somebody ought to praise his holy name.
You are healed. In Jesus' name.
Come on and testify. You
are
you
healed.
Know what I'm saying.
Decree and declare your healing on this morning.
Come on and lift your voice.
In that very spot, in that very area that the doctors say that they don't know what to do.
Come on and say,
lay your
awesome.
Hands on that very area that you've got to even report on.
Awesome.
And watch God heal.
Come on and say, awesome.
And if your heart has been broken, lay your
come
hands on your
believe,
heart.
Lift your voice.
And ask God to bring you back together. Lay hands on your mind.
Come on, somebody say,
and
he's
God
mighty.
Peace
he's
in your mind.
He's mighty.
Some of us
he's
can't even
mighty,
sleep at night. over. You are forgiving God. He forgives us over and over and over and over again. We're not perfect. We make mistakes all the time. But thank God for the mercy of God. Thank God for the grace of God. Thank God that He don't hold us accountable for the things we have done. So God, we thank You. And so if you're holding any type of unforgiveness in your heart towards anybody, I ask you right now that you forgive them, because we want God to forgive us. Don't hold on to grudges. Don't worry about what they did, what they did not do. Don't worry about those things. God said give them to God, because some of us are holding things and we cannot go forward. Some of us are holding things in our heart that we can't even love people. God is compelling us to love. But we got too much hang up in us that we don't know how to love. We'll rather hate and cut them off before we love and compel them to come to Christ. And people are busting hell wide open because the children of God are not going after those that are struggling. We're talking about them too much. We ride down the street and we see them on the corner, and instead of us blessing them and praying for them, we put our mouths on them. But whatever you sow, you don't want to reap back. Because some of us have children. Some of us have grandchildren. You don't want to put your mouth on nobody else and have to reap that thing. So come on. God wants to use us in a special way. Come on. The battle is God's and it's not ours. We're trying to fight battles that don't belong to us. We're trying to fight battles that we know we can't even win. We're in spiritual battles. Only God can see us through. Only God can fight those battles for us. Come on, if you want to lay at His feet, come lay at His feet and say, God, I'm tired. The battle is too heavy. It's too much for me. I'm trying to hold it down for everybody. The weight of my family is on me. The weight of my family is around. The weight of my job, whatever it is. God said He wants you to be free so that He can use you. He wants to use you for His glory. He wants to use you for His service. So God, we thank You. No matter what your battle is, if you're battling sickness, addiction, pornography, your finances, whatever it is, you're battling with your spouses, your children, whatever it is, your mental health, your mind, whatever you're battling with, God said He's the one that's going to fight for you. God said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. He will do the impossible. He will do the impossible for you. He will work that thing out for you. And some of our trials is to get our attention. Because what happened is, if you don't have certain trials, you'll kind of back away from God. You'll get comfortable. And God is saying, my sons and my daughters, they're too comfortable. And now I'm going to have to stir up a little bit because I need their attention. Some things God has allowed you to go through. There are some things God is allowing you to face because He's working something out. God said, count it all joy when you go through certain trials, because in those trials, it's when you learn who God really is. In those trials is when you learn that God is really a healer when He heals you. You learn when you go through that God is really a way maker when He makes a way out of no way for you. You get to learn it for yourself. You get to learn that God has not left you, abandoned you, when He supernaturally began to put things in your midst. So God, we thank You. We worship You all today. So no matter what your battle is, come on and praise Him. Know that God is working it out. He's working something out in you. There's some things that God want to work out in us because He wants to use you. He wants you fit to be used for those that are still out there, for those that are still struggling. God has taken you into a place, not for bad, but for good. That you have a testimony, and in your testimony you bring forth healing for others. So God, we thank You on this morning. Come on and bless God. Come on and worship Him. Come on and love on Him this morning. He's been too good. He's been too kind. Come on and bless him. Some things we're going through, it's not for bad. It's not for bad. It's for good. God is working something out for your good. Come on and bless him. Come on and bless him. Happy Appreciation Day, Bishop Barbara. Oh, we thank God for the woman of God. We thank God for her life. We thank God that God has done something special. That the enemy thought he was going to have her, but his past was not good enough. So we salute her on this morning. We worship her.
Come on, put your hands together. Let's give Jesus the praise. Let's sing it. Hallelujah. you love to praise the Lord? Come on, put your hands together. Let's make a joyful shout to God in this place tonight. Hallelujah.
Been good to you. Come on, has God been good? Give him a thunder praise. Put those hands together. He's so worthy. I say he's so worthy. He didn't have to do what he did for us. He woke us up. We need to see another day and we can come together as family and friends today. Look at someone and say, I'm so happy to be with you today. God is a good God. It's good to be together. God loves families. I said, God loves families. Hallelujah. Put a smile on your face. Let you know that means God just loves you so much. I don't know about nobody, but I'm grateful to be here today. I mean, I'm grateful today because he have kept me all these years. He done brought all of us a long ways. So many people not here to tell the story. But can't nobody tell your story like you can tell your story. If you've been through something, you should be giving God a praise here today. And I mean a hallelujah praise today like never before. Because God been good. He been good. He been good. Amen. We're going to hear a couple more songs. We're going to move into the service. I'm so grateful to be here. See all of you.
I need everybody to clap your hands right now. Come on. Come on, clap them up in the air. Here's a message we want to send to the Lord. Come on.
All I need.
Hey.
Every breath you breathe through me.
You're all I need.
You're all I need.
Come on, people.
Let your rivers.
Rivers flow through me.
Everybody say
you're all I need. Stand and stand. Come on, if you can. Come on.
Every breath.
We're going to celebrate this day.
Come on, y'all got it. Come on.
You're all I need.
Yeah.
Let your rivers flow through me.
You're all I need.
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 Come on. You're all that I need.
You're all I need.
Come on. Come on. gonna try to go out and do anything without going straight to God. He knows what's best for us. Amen. Well, he said, acknowledge him in all your ways and let him direct your path. And, you know, just call on Jesus. He's there for you. Amen. Amen. Say amen again. Amen. Is God good? Sometime. He's a good God all the time. My heart that this song, you know, I was just thanking God so much all week for enabling me to be here. Some of you may know, some don't. I had a triple bypass on the 2nd of June. And to God be all the glory. Yeah, I'm able to be out. I've been out here like 2 months already doing what God helped me to do. Ain't no stopping me now. Yeah, devil, his best shot ain't good enough. Am I right, Karen? His best shot ain't good enough. No. I know somebody. I can't make it without this somebody. How many of you know you can't make it without him? When everybody else fails, he going to be there. I said, he's going to be there for you. He's never going to leave you. He's never going to forsake you. I don't want you to put your trust in no man. Don't put your trust in nothing, but put it in God and see what he brings you through. Anybody, do I get an amen in here? Do I get a witness in the house? To those that's watching by live stream, God bless you. Happy to have you celebrating with us today, too, on this beautiful day. It's like when we put it aside, usually third Sunday in October, we do for family and friends. But when I looked at the calendar, I realized it's my spiritual birthday. Amen. So today, God, I accepted Christ 39 years ago today. And out of those 39 years, God had really kept me. He started delivering me 2 months after I got saved. In 10 months' time, God had taken away the things I thought I needed, this flesh needed, the alcohol, the smoking, the cursing, the sex. He moved it all. And I ain't touched none of those things in 38 years. So to God be the glory. See, I had a ready made up mind. When your mind made up, you can do it. I've been sick and tired of being sick and tired. Y'all ain't getting what I'm saying. I was sick and tired of looking in the mirror, my eyes bloodshot. Not only from the alcohol, from the beating me in my face. I want to call no name. But I was tired. I said, God, if you're real, I'm going to serve you till the day I die. I made up my mind. You got to make up your mind, people. This man is the best thing that could ever happen to you. The spirit that comes inside of you, let him take control of your life. Yes. Can't nobody do you like Jesus. Don't wait till something happens and you got to call on him. Call on him now while you got a chance. Give him all your best shot. Give it to him now. Amen. Come on. So when I went under that knife, I looked at them lights. I said, well, God, I'm in your hand. Whatever you do, your will be done. I'm all right with it. And I went on out. Next thing I know, I was looking around. So, you brought me back here. I'm in intensive care here. But you know what? The peace that I had, I never had it like that before. Whatever what God did with me, I was just pleased with it. Because I know, when you know that you've been serving God, and I'm not perfect. No, I'm not perfect. Nobody's perfect. But I try to give God my best. Because God gives us his best. He's a mighty good God. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Have God brought you through something and you know if it had not been the Lord that was on your side, you wouldn't be here today. Say amen. Amen. I'm telling you. Amen. Y'all don't get me going up in here because I could tell a good story here. God been good to me. He been good to you, all of you. He been good to. I'm looking at all your faces. He been good to you. Whether you want to say it or not, I say God been good to you. You need to give him a thunder praise because he's been good. I say, God been good. I give him everything I can give him. I don't care where I'm at. I'm going to lift up the name of Jesus because he's so worthy. He's so worthy. I say, he's so worthy. Amen. It's a song that I'm still standing. After all I've been through. Anybody want to sing with me on that one? I want to hear that because I've been through some stuff. But I'm still here. I'm still standing. You've been through, you're still here. Look at somebody say, I'm still standing. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Is that the one I want? Thank you.
I'm still standing.
Come on, sing with me.
Here I am. After all I've been through, I survive.
Come on, sing with me,
people. Every toil, every snare. I'm alive. I'm alive. Here I am.
Come on, come on. You can sing it with me.
Oh, 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 yes. There were times when I almost gave up, and I've cried. Lord, it's too much. El Shaddai,
you guys know what I'm talking
He
about.
Was there all the time. By His grace, He is keeping me alive. By His grace and mercy, I'm still standing, standing.
Come on, people.
I'm standing in the presence of the Almighty with power and the testimony. I'm standing here today with one thing to say,
Lord, I thank you.
I thank you.
Thank you.
But here I am.
Yes, God.
I'm still standing.
Come on, come on.
Here I am. After all I've been through,
I survive. Every toil, every snare, I'm alive.
I'm alive.
I'm alive.
But I'm defeated. I say he's defeated. I say he's defeated. Look at someone and say, aren't you glad we can come together on this beautiful day? It's a beautiful day. It's a beautiful day. I say it's such a beautiful day. Ooh, I don't know what y'all, but I'm glad to be here. To see each and every one of you, my family. This is how it's going to be in heaven one day. So come on, get used to it, baby. God ain't got no this and that. He does everybody. And he is so awesome. Now he knows how to do it right well. Amen. Say amen. Say amen again. I'm just happy today.
Honor and power unto the Lord our God. For the Lord our God is mighty. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, He is wonderful.
That's it. Lift it up to Him and sing it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Salvation
and glory.
Give Him honor and power.
Honor and power unto the Lord our God.
For the Lord our God is mighty.
For the Lord our God is mighty.
Yes, He is.
Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent.
Come on, call Him the Lord.
The Lord.
He gets the highest praise. Yes. 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 Yes, God. We give you the highest praise today, God. Because you're so worthy. Yeah, you're worthy.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
come to lift up every praise unto the Lord today. You better praise Him while you got a chance. Nobody know about no tomorrow. And we don't even know the next day or the rest of the day. That's why we got to do what we got to do. Because when it's night, no man can praise Him. Got to praise Him. Now, don't be ashamed to open up your mouth and praise Him. You know what God done for you? Don't sit here and be cute. This ain't no place to sit up and be cute at. No, 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 no. I could run up and down this aisle. Ooh, sometimes I just feel like just throwing this mic and getting loose up in here. Yeah, because I know what He's been good to me. I mean, I said, He's been good to me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And He ain't finished yet. Yeah. No, He ain't finished yet. No, He ain't finished. No, no. 82 is just a number. I'm 82, but I got a long ways to go. I'm going to see 100. I say, I'm going to see 100. You speak it. Call those things that be not what you wanted to be speaking. And I will see 100 in Jesus' name. Hey, right now, come on, come on. I'm going to see 100 in Jesus' name. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That song about at the church. Come on, I want y'all to sing. I ain't heard it's a long song, but it's a good song. We got to say amen. Say amen, folks. Say amen. Say amen. Let's pray for Israel first. It's just...
I want to introduce to you right now.
Most gracious Heavenly Father, we just come with a humble heart. Just please touch right now, God. It's such a heaviness in my heart, and I'm sure in so many other hearts, to see what's going on over in the Holy Land and what they're doing to the kids and the elderly and the people. Just, oh my God, the death, I don't even want to look at it. I just try not to even see it. But God, I know you say just pray. And we're going to come together and pray today. You all can pray in the spirit. But God, we just come to lift up, God, that you move by your spirit and put an end to this war. Please, God, put an end to this war in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you for moving by your spirit right now. Move like never before, God. Stop it right now. Right now, you are right now, God. You can put a stop to it and let peace be upon Jerusalem. We say, pray for Jerusalem, that peace, God. We ask for peace to be over there, God. Do it right now. Put a stop to every scheme, every plot, every wicked device, everything. Satan, we rebuke you. We bind you. We come against your spirits that you have put this hate in the people's heart. No, it's just over as of today. Right now, it's over in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, God going to turn our hearts to Him, and they're going to love one another. God, do it right now. You can do it. Nothing is too hard, impossible for you to do. God, it's a trick of the enemy, and we bind his workers, bind that murder and that hate spirit. We bind every spirit been sent out against those that want to do right. God, there's so many people got love, and they don't deserve this death that's coming up on them. But God, I know you're able to do it, and I'm asking in Jesus' name as we all come together. We come together. We know it's going to be done right because we put it in your hand to do it right. In Jesus' name, amen. Say amen, amen. Keep praying for Jerusalem, please. I say keep praying for Jerusalem, amen.
Say let there be peace over there, amen. Amen. Mm-hmm.
Everybody.
Say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church. Say,
because people don't even know where they're going.
Marvin Whining.
They don't even know where they're going to lay their heads.
Be blessed.
They got to complain about something because you ain't got the money to buy some shoes or something. Please. Yeah, people ain't got no feet to wear no shoes now. Oh, come on, Jesus. Come on. I say, come on, Jesus. Oh, my God. Oh, come on, baby. I'm telling you, so I said.
Let the church say amen.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church, say.
Say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church.
To what his word
say
says.
God has spoken.
Let the church
say
amen. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Make this your response
amen.
To what
glory, he said.
Amen.
From the healing of your body,
amen,
to the raising of the dead.
Amen.
No matter how you're feeling,
amen,
or how your world is reeling,
amen,
battle on through the night,
amen,
'cause you're gonna win the fight.
Amen.
Help is on the way.
Help is on the way. Help is on the way.
I heard him.
So
let the church say,
oh,
lift your hands wherever you are and let the church.
Amen.
Let the church say.
God has spoken.
Hallelujah.
Let the church
say,
amen.
All we needed was a word from the Lord. We've got it, so
let
the church
say, amen.
Oh,
let
the whole church
say, amen.
God has spoken. Well, 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 let the church.
Let
the church say,
say
let the church say,
amen.
Oh,
come on, come on, come on.
I need you to say it.
Amen.
When your dream's about to die.
Amen.
Knowing that God is not a man.
Amen.
He just can't lie.
Amen.
In spite of what?
Yes.
What the devil does.
In spite of what the devil does.
No, you've got a word.
Yes.
That has come from above.
Yes.
Faith must be.
Yes.
Must be in what you say.
Yes.
So open your mouth.
Woo!
And say amen today. Because
God,
I heard him when he said it.
Let the church.
Let the church
say.
Let the church say, yeah.
God has spoken.
God has spoken.
Let the church.
I feel it in my spirit.
Say,
oh, 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 oh.
God has spoken.
Everybody all over the world.
Let the church.
Let the believers
say.
Already done. We are all in agreement. Let the church say amen. Whatever you go through, we all say amen. Because we know he has spoken, he's going to do what he says. Amen. He's a God. He would never lie. He's a son of man. He should only have to repent. What he said, it's going to happen. Have God spoke something good to you that he's going to do? I got two. I don't know about you, but I receive God getting ready to do something great. And I know he has spoken. He's going to do what he says. Amen. Say amen. Amen, amen. You may be snow. Let's have the reason and decree before you sit down because I have you stand right back up. Okay. You ready? Okay. And I release.
Peace of God, family, power, and divine help, prosperity, and abundance in all things. The peace of God has established our mind. Long life and a life worth living. Unity in the spirit and unbroken change of the love of God. Are the angels to keep my family safe and sound in all their ways. The power of God to be the lender and not the borrower, the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. We the inventions of God, we got the gifts for success in Jesus' name.
Amen. Decree.
I shall also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. Job 22:28. I decree over my family, freedom from sickness and disease, freedom from lack and despair, freedom from torment and depression, freedom from premature death and strokes,
freedom from divorce and family alienation, freedom from accidents, freakish things, vandalism, and violence, freedom from debt, car notes, and mortgage payments.
In Jesus' name. Amen. We got to put the rent in there because some people paying rent too. Amen. Amen. What's that? You know what? We just celebrating today. What? Yeah, you may be seated, but I'm going to have it. I like that song, You Pray For Me, I Pray For You. What's that song? Anybody know what I'm talking about? This is the time we got to learn how to pray for one another. What's the name of that song? Oh, I know Karen's going to do it. I know she's going to do it. Yes, sir, Karen. Go ahead, girl. I will survive. Amen. You pray for me and I pray for you. Amen. Say amen. All right, all right. I'm so happy to see all these people in here today. God knows God is good. Yes.
I need you. You need me.
Yes.
We're all a part of God's body. Stand with me.
I need you.
Agree with me. We're all a part of God's body. It is His will that every need be supplied. You are important.
With your family.
I need you to survive.
Family, come on, give us so much close family.
Are important to me. I need you to survive.
Everybody, look at somebody and tell them, I need you.
I need you.
You need me.
You need me.
We're all apart.
We're all apart of God's body.
Stand with me.
Stand with me.
Look at somebody, tell them, agree with me.
Agree with
me. We're all a part.
We're all a part of God's body.
It is His will.
It is His will that every need be supplied. You are important to me. I need you to survive.
Somebody
here to tell me, I won't harm you with words from
You really need someone, you know? When you start going through things, you really need them, you know? Yeah, when you're doing well and you're on your feet, we still need, but it's nothing like when you're on your back and you need someone. Just a phone call or send a call to kind of cheer you along the way. And just keep praying for each other, you know? Prayer is the key to everything. Amen? Amen. Say amen. Amen. Yeah, that song was on my heart all week. Because I know it was coming up to Family and Friends Day, and I just, God brought it back to my memory. How many of you know God bring all things back to your memory? He will bring it back to your memory. So I'm not going to prolong here. I'm just going to move on to the benevolence, please, and do our offering, and I'm going to get the word, and we're going to be ready to move on. Amen. Ooh, so many people that I don't know. We have first-time visitors here. Can you please stand? I'd love to see you. I'm not putting you on the spot. It's your first time being here. Please, oh my God. Come on, give God a prayer. Y'all get out your seat and give somebody some love. Shake their hands and welcome them here. Amen. Thank God for you coming here today. Oh my God, it's such a blessing. It's a blessing. In the love of Jesus, no kidding, that you come and visit with us today. God bless you. Anyone have something they want to say? I don't want to put nobody on no spot. Good to see y'all. Amen. Bless you. Thank you. Well, I truly thank God for you coming out. You're welcome in this house, not only for this Sunday, but anytime you feel like you want to come in, just come right here and we're going to fellowship together. Amen. Amen. We bless you to be here today, and I pray that you get something out of the service and you go out of here, if you're not saved, please get saved. And if you're in a road or backsliding, you know, just come and give your heart back to Christ. Amen? Amen. It's so important these days. We don't know from 1 minute to the next what's coming down or what's coming up, but we know that we got to get our house in order now. Amen. You're doing anything you know is displeasing to God and you accepted Christ, don't continue to do it because that's not pleasing to Him. Amen? Amen. Let's get right with God now while we have a chance. Amen? Amen. You're getting away, you think you're getting away, but you're not really getting away with anything because God sees and knows everything. Amen? Amen. Amen. It's the benevolence, you take up the benevolence in the offering, and we're going to move right on into the service. Amen? Amen.
I've celebrated, sweet drink I've tasted, they come and go. But there was a treasure poured without measure over the earth. A light that's so bright it outshines the brightest lights of the world. No greater. Oh,
encourage you guys to remember who God is, all right? Remember that He is the greatest. Remember that He has all power. And remember that He never has a bad day. So it doesn't matter what it looks like or what you feel like. How many know that God is still in control? Hey, if it's greater, then let Him be greater.
Serve Him, He's still good to us. Amen. So it's our reasonable service that we should always put Him first in everything we do. Make sure you, off the top of your income or whatever your first fruit, give it to God. And you'll see how you'll be blessed. You know why so many people struggle and have no idea? Because they don't do what they're supposed to do with their money. God give you the power to get the wealth, but hey, you go do what you want to do and let God say, I get it next week, and next week comes something else. So the enemy going to always block, keep you from giving to God. Amen? Amen. Say amen. Amen. Father, we thank and praise You for this opportunity. We can come to Your house to give for the building of Your kingdom. We present the finances to You, God. We ask You to multiply, increase them, that we are more than enough to meet every need in this house. Be able to go outside these four walls and be a blessing to someone else that may have a need. Father, in Jesus' name, I ask that You bless every cent that came even for myself. I ask that you bless it, Father, and that I can give back more than you have to give me. And I thank you for doing that, God. Bless this house and everyone that was able to give, even though that's giving on live stream. Let them have a 100-fold return come back up on them for their giving, because they're obedience unto you. And I thank you for doing it. In Jesus' name we pray. Say amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen again. Amen. God is good. Right. I don't know what's going now. Birthdays and anniversary. Birthdays, anniversary. Please. Birthdays and anniversary. Wow. Come on up here. All right. Birthdays, anniversary. We have a birthday, it's your first time here, and we still want you to come. We want to bless you. Anniversary. We are family. We are family. Come on. Say amen.
Amen.
God is good. Come on, we're going to be, let you be blessed today. If it's not your birthday, just let somebody that's coming up here and get their birthday blessing. Amen. Ooh, what a friend we have in Jesus. All right, Mama, come on up here. All right. Anywhere you want to stand. In the middle, in the ends, you got it. All right, there, Kath. Look at you, girl. Why are you taking so long to come up here? You could have shouted up here. God is good. Okay, we're going to start on the end here. Your name and your birthday. Oh, okay. Okay,
your name and birthday will be October 7th.
Okay.
I'm standing for my oldest son, Jeffrey, turning 34 tomorrow.
All right.
He gave us our first
grandchild. All right, now. All right, now. All right, granddaddy. Okay, now, come on, baby. Your name and your birthday? Today, all right. And how old are you today? How old are you today? Huh? How old? Yeah, y'all got to get you married off, boy. Okay. I got to get you married off. Okay, Tiffany. Huh? All right, Tiff, 40. All right, now. All right, Mom. Your name and your birthday? All right. Well, go ahead, Monterey. You 51? You better shut your mouth. All right, go ahead, Mr. Crawford.
Tariq Crawford, my birthday is tomorrow, and I'll be
47. All right, now. All right. Okay. Your name and your birthday.
My name is Beverly Bentley. I'm here on behalf of my, she's like a dream, Fantasia.
Okay.
Amen. My birthday is October 23rd. Amen.
You be what? How old are you going to be?
60s.
You be in your 60s, right? Okay, come on, Kat.
All right.
That's right, Kat. All right, give God the glory. Amen. Amen. Will you bow your heads? Maybe you want to just thank God for something he's done for you or what you'd like for him to do. For a moment, just you can pray silent to yourself about your head. Amen. Father, I thank and praise you for each and every one standing here before you. Thank you for letting them see another birthday. Thank you for blessing them. God, I ask most of all that you give them desires of their heart. God, you know the needs of each and every one standing before you, and you have kept them here to see another birthday, and you kept them here with a purpose. So whatever your will is, let your will be done in their lives. Let your divine and perfect will be in their lives right now. Anything the enemy trying to attack upon them, say to them, I rebuke you from them right now, bind you. I command that you go right now in the name of Jesus. And God, I release them into your hand, your spirit. Have your way with each and every one standing before you today and bless them as they go on their journey to another birthday. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, everybody. Happy birthday to you. God's blessings on you. God's blessings on you. God's blessings on everybody. God's blessings on you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Enjoy your cupcake. I got one over there, right? Bless your heart. Amen. God bless you all. Amen. God is good. All the time, God is good. You have a dance? I just love you, girl.
I love you more.
Okay, what you up to?
You gotta have a seat.
I gotta sit down. I'm ready to preach.
I know. God bless everyone. Thank you for coming to our Family and Friends Day on today. It is so crowded. We welcome you all. But today is Pastor Appreciation Month. So we celebrate our pastor every month. And it happens to fall on her spiritual birthday. 39 years, she said yes to the call. And so we have one presentation that I'm going to have one special guest come up real quick, and that's going to be Karen. And so today, Bishop, my family, we honor you. If my family and friends could stand up, we honor you on today. Because not only is this my church, all my family is Bishop's pastor. And all of them, if you check their cell phones, they all have her phone number in it. To where not only do I have to be in the midst, they will call her on their own. We appreciate you all, Bishop. We appreciate you so much for taking time for our family, never saying no, always there, whatever it is. But I'm going to let...
Good morning, good afternoon, everyone. As Lynn stated, Bishop is not only Rita and Lynn's pastor, she is all of our pastor. And I just want to say to each and every one of you today, especially to her family, thank you so much for sharing her with us. I thank God for Lynn Call coming in 1997, right? I'm right, right? 98. And sticking and staying, because you have no idea the blessing you have been, not just to Lynn and Rita, but to our entire family. We thank you so much. We thank you so, so, so much for all that you have done, for the many, many prayers. People don't even know. They don't even know. They don't even have no idea the prayers that you have set in my family, my friends, my coworkers. You have never said no. And Bishop, we couldn't pay you enough for the blessings that you have given us. We just want to let you know that we love you, we honor you, we appreciate you, and we love you. And again, Renee, Fatima, Kiana, and all, thank you so much for sharing her with us. You guys have no idea. I could stand here, like she said, the devil... The best shot is not good enough. She has prayed me through many things. Even when I didn't know she was praying. And I'm so grateful. I am so grateful. The devil tried me this year with my dad. And he tried me again last week with my brother. But let me tell you something. But God. And because I know a woman like you, I know how to pray. And I know how to thank God, even in the midst of my storm. In the midst of my storm, Bishop, I know how to get a prayer up. I wasn't worried. I called Lynn, and I said, huh, devil, you a lie. And I kept eating. That's what I was doing. I was eating. And I kept eating. I kept eating. I told my sister-in-law, I said, call me back. And then I called my mother and let her know. I kept eating because he wasn't going to have neither one of them. Neither one of them. But again, Bishop, I could go on and on and on. And Lynn, I didn't come up to say, Butter, because that's what y'all know him by. Kennard, my baby. He will be 26 on the 27th of this month. And my cousin Wanda sat in the back. She'll be 59 on the 21st. And my niece Tiffany turned 28 on the 23rd of September. So again, Bishop, you, girl, you in there. Yeah. Again, we just want to say thank you. We honor you. We appreciate you. And we love you. 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 Thank you so much for it all. They don't even know. They don't even know we get hood and everything, don't we? They don't know how to call you and say Bishop. But I say they still dealing with me.
Oh, I want to thank each and every one. I know Glenn's mother, and I think I knew Rainey before I knew any of them.
Yeah,
back in the day. Yeah. Rainey. Oh, Rainey. Now, we go back in the day before we were saved. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. Rainey, so happy I met you, and I met everybody in your family through you. I'm so sorry that Gladys couldn't be here, her and James.
She watching.
Gladys, thank you so much, you and James. Lynn was at my house, was it Friday night? Thursday night. And James called, and Lynn said, I'm here with Bishop. So he said, hey, Bishop, hey. So he said, I'm trying to get ready for something to give you for your anniversary, right? I said to myself, you go so far back, you just can't, you never have no idea when God have you meet up with someone from the world, and we partied, we danced, we did things from the world. And now here we praising God together. And the children is growing up. You see how your children are growing up. Mother, how you doing with your back, okay? I chose and lay hands on that back enough, right? God is good, right? I'm so grateful. I'm so full right now that I'm just so full to see all of you come out and celebrate with us today. Thank God for you. 100-fold return back on everyone that even sold into my life today. This, your presence means more than the money. Let me say. See, people look at money. There's things I do money. Your presence, I do this here. See, when I lay down at night and think about all of you was here, that means more than this money. See, people think it's money. No, it's the presence of you all being here. Took time to come from your church and be here with me today. I'm so grateful for that. Amen. God bless you so much. And 100-fold come back upon this family. Amen. Amen.
So, if you all would like to sow, there is a basket up in the front. Danica, put some music on. Let's sow into the woman of God. Let's bless her on today. She's been such a blessing to us. She's never said no. No matter what time it was, she's always answered the call. So, if you would like to bless the woman of God on her spiritual birthday for pastor's appreciation, please do so at the moment. Her Cash App is Bishop Barbara Glanton. If you would like to sow it directly to her Cash App, thank you so much.
Kenyatta. Yeah. Kenyatta in the house. Look at here. Oh my God.
Something God is about to take place. Something good is about to happen. Something God is about to take something good is about to happen. You say it. Something God is about to take place. Say something good is about to happen. You can't have it if you won't say it. Say it's about to take place. Listen, something good is about to happen. Something God is about Y'all listen, it's gonna be good. God told me to prophesy, it's gonna be good. Tell somebody, it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good. Hey, it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good. Can't have it if you won't say it. One more time, say it. Something God. It's gonna be God. Somebody say, Bishop, I hear you, but I don't know how it's gonna happen. It's gonna be God. I wish I had some people of faith in the room tonight. Look at somebody and prophesy. Say, it's gonna be God. Tell them again, it's gonna be God.
It's gonna be God.
Everybody say, something good. Trying to give you something to put in the heavens is about to take place. One more time. We gotta go, Dante. Somebody clap your hands if you know it's going to be God. I'm telling y'all, while we're standing here worshiping, God is working on stuff.
She's like, I don't even know what to say. She's jumping on the spot with me. Now that's enough. You got to sit down now. You know you can keep doing this and you can't keep doing that. So I'm asking, now can I sit? She said, yes, okay. I'm going to move. Y'all can move this here. It's a dance. You got it? Okay.
No, leave. It's just on this side. Okay. Gotcha. That's good.
the valley, through the mud. I won't worry, I won't fear, 'cause no weapon formed against me shall prosper. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. Whoa. Through the fire, through the flood, through the valley,
through the mud,
said I won't worry. Sickness and disease.
attack against my family. Try to attack my mind. Try to steal my time.
One time, hey.
It's
like the devil's shifting. We might shouldn't have started with that one.
It won't.
That thing will stick you right there. I want you to think of all the things that the enemy is trying to throw your way. I want you to get that on your mind. I can't leave that alone until you get those things on your mind and say, it won't.
Come on, give God a praise.
might have been right. We might should have started with that one. It won't.
Wow.
That thing will stick you right there.
You can remain standing.
I want you to think of all the things that the enemy is trying to throw your way.
What you putting your hand in for me for? I had no idea that. And put the chair there. I didn't know it was for me to come up this. She ain't saying no, just still. Just lift me up. Thank you, guys. It was a beautiful dance. To God be the glory. Amen. It has been really beautiful. Thanks for everything. I'm not going to hold you but like 10 hours, and then you can go, okay? We're doing really good. We usually get out around this time. So I'm going to just give you a word. If you have your Bibles, you can turn to Genesis, the 12th chapter. Remain standing. We read 3 verses and go from there. Amen? I really want to thank everyone that come out to celebrate this Family and Friends Day. And thank God for the 39 years he kept me. I meant what I said to him when I said it. I meant it. I was sick and tired of the world and what it was doing to me. And I do believe if I hadn't said yes and kept going, I wouldn't be here today. Amen. The devil would have had his way and taken me out of here. It was an assignment to take me out because he knew for me to walk with God that I was going to try to tear up his territory. So I thank God for all of you here. I love all of you. Some of you I know, some I don't. But you know what? It's okay because if you keep striving, we all going to be to heaven one day. Amen? Amen. Amen. There ain't going to be no color this, that. We all going to have a good time in heaven. So that's what you strive to get to heaven. Amen. Amen. Not all this material stuff and all that, but it's good to have a nice thing because I like the little nice thing, but it's my treasure is not in that. I love to win souls for the kingdom of God, and I like to see backsliders come back. It was so beautiful. I got 2 calls yesterday from 2 people that I hadn't heard from and hadn't seen, and it was just a blessing. You know, I'm so grateful that I don't hold anything in my heart against anyone. And when they called, I would just treat them just like they was always been there. I was like, God bless you. I'm so happy to hear from you. You know, I was just so, and really, I truly was happy to hear from them. Amen? Because anything could have happened since the time I talked with them, but God is good. And he has a way. If you let God fight your battles, he'll fight them every time. Amen? He will. Amen? So we're going to start reading at verse 1. Then you may be seated. Now the Lord has said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show thee. And I will make of thee a great nation and will bless thee and make thy name great. And I shall be a blessing. And I will bless them that bless thee and curse him that curse thee. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. All the families be blessed. When you write your whole seed, your whole family. Amen. When you bless, and God blessing you, he ain't only bless you. Your seeds and your seeds and your seeds will be blessed. Say amen. Amen. So whatever you're doing, just keep on doing it. I don't care how rough they're acting, they're going to come on in anyway. Say amen. I want you to be seated. And this is what God gave me. God is making your name great. I said, God is making your name great. I guess I have to say it again. God is making your name great. And you will be a blessing upon this earth. There are people that God has really set apart. And they have been blessed and they bless others. The more you give out, the more come back to you. Ain't nobody hearing what I'm saying. I look at somebody and say, I know God getting ready to make my name great. Because all that I've been going through with it, got to be something good coming out of it. And if I could just hold my peace and let the Lord fight my battles, I ain't got to worry about who talk about me. I ain't got to worry about who put me down. Because God got me. He got my name written in the palm of his hand. He get ready to pull you up, baby, and make your name great. Everybody going to know you. Look at somebody say, everybody going to know me. So these things that's coming on me is just for the enemy. Because you know God getting ready to do something. I don't care what you've been going through. Just look at what I say. You know what, devil, you didn't get me then. You ain't getting me now. So your best shot ain't good enough. Look at somebody say, I know God getting ready to turn some things around. Because the enemy been on my trail for a while now. But it's all right. And the more he be on my trail, the more higher I'm getting up. God said, I'm going to make your name great. But Abraham proved to God that he was really, really ready. So you can't just talk it. You got to put something there to get it. I say amen. You got to put something there. And I'm telling you, when you do right with people and continue to do what's right, God will truly bless you. And out of nowhere, you're going to be like, how in the world did God do this for me? Because God getting ready to open up a door. I told you the other day, there's a door getting ready to open. I don't know what y'all looking for, but I'm here to tell you. You may, maybe nobody know you right now, but say, keep watching me. My name would be great. And I would be great before God. Not because man, but I'm being great before God. Because when God start promoting, you see, promotion don't come from man. Not the east or the west, it come from God. So God got his eyes on somebody getting ready to be promoted. God getting ready to make you. How did that person do? I mean, they didn't have nothing. That's when God used you. He said he don't take that person that got everything and bring them up. He takes somebody that's down there. Because they're going to give him some glory. Anybody know what I'm talking about? See, I didn't get all the education either, but I know how to give God some glory. I know how to thank him for what he done for me. I know he have did a great work in me. How many of you know he done did a work in you? And those that bless me, they be blessed. Amen. Those that curse me, they be cursed. Now that's the word of God. Lord, help me, Jesus. I'm trying to do this right. I'm trying to do it right. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. You see, God sent his one and only Son to die for this whole sinful world. Why would he come back just for everybody? So that he can take us back to heaven as a family. God loves families. So if you got any strife in your heart, be like what Abraham. Let there be no strife. Let there be no. It's time to come together. Now ain't no time for no bickering and arguing. It's time to come together. Amen. Look at somebody and say, I got to get it right. Because there are some people I know I ain't right with. Come on now. Ain't no time to be getting strife going. Because strife bring on curses. Amen. I got to get right because I got some things. I'm not going to let you miss out. I ain't going to let you call me to miss out on my blessing. Because you ain't even worth me losing no sleep over you. You ain't worth me losing nothing over you. Because, see, I know God getting ready to do something. How many of you know? Because you know how I know if he's going to do something because of all what I'm going through right now. Anybody hear what I'm saying? God said, I will make your name great, but you're going to have to go through something. When he tested Abraham to take his one and only son. Come on, I think it's in, I'm not quite sure, it's what chapter 22, I think. I'm not sure. But anyway, Abraham did what he told him. He took his son, two gods with him, and he said, come on. And then Isaac said, well, where's the ram? Where's the sacrifice? Where's the ram? He said, you it. Can you imagine? To tell your child, I'm taking you so I can give you to God. I'm getting ready to chop your head off. So that proved right there that God said, this I know by what you're doing now. That you fear me. That you fear me. That you're going to do what I said. Sometimes we got to go through something so God can really see, can I trust you? See, he don't make your name record. He said, I'm going to put you somewhere, but I'm going to see, can I trust you to do what I ask you to do? Or are you going to try to get all the glory? Come on now. You better be careful with that. Don't ever try to get God glory around here. God said, I'm going to take you through something. I'm talking to family now. You get big and you forget about your sisters and your brothers and people. Amen. You don't reach back and help nobody. It's family, right? Family and friends, they right? Is it family and friends? Did we set this apart for family and friends? Nothing breaks me no more when I see people close to their family. Because when your family lets you down, you down. You better stay close to your family because when you're depending on your friends, they may not be there. But God will give you a friend. He said, I know somebody that stick closer to you as a friend than any brother, anybody. That name is Jesus. Amen. I know somebody going to be there for you when nobody else going to be there for you. So what I'm saying to you, sometimes we want to point fingers, but don't point no fingers. Just say, God, help me to get it right. Because if they don't like me, it must be something that's stirring. Because you go to the pot and ain't nothing in, you can't stir nothing in there, right? But if they can come to your pot and stir something in it, got to be something in it. So you need to go check yourself before you talk about them. Amen. I pray for you. You pray for me. I won't let nothing come out of my mouth against you. That's a lie. Because many of you sang that song and you know you're lying. I won't harm you with words that come out my mouth. Oh, Father, forgive us. Okay, hey. You know what? I ain't gonna say a word over there. I hear you over there. I ain't gonna even look your way. I'm gonna Romans 4 here. Let me read you Romans 4 to you, okay? This is sad. This is really good here. God is good. He's ready for us to get it right. We sit up in church every Sunday, go back and forth and leave out of here just with too much hardness in our heart. Let's get it right. Some people say, I'll be trying to tell somebody, well, that ain't me. That's you. If I'm going to tell you something, I know how I made it over. And I'm going to give you some advice how you're going to get over. Then you should try to do it too. Amen. Don't sit and think because you have got up a ladder, one notch up. There can't nobody tell you nothing. See, the Bible said be swift to listen and slow to speak. And so for the wrath, amen? So when you get, you step up one step higher, and then you get there, and you think because you're getting a little disc going for you. Be careful how you act when you get there. Be careful how you treat your loved ones when you get there. This family friend day, right? Be careful when you know you got a sister or a neighbor that needs some help, and you don't help them. Be careful. Because just as sure you got it, you can lose it. I say, as sure you got it, you can lose it. Can I say it again? You got to be careful. Don't get so big that you can't help nobody else. I said, don't get so big that you can't help nobody else. It's time that we come together. I've never seen it like it is now, and I'm not trying to bring nobody down, but the way it is today is like crabs. If you can't help nobody, you're pulling them down. And I want to call no nomination. No race, creeds, or nothing that, but some things I just can't get with because instead of someone helping someone or saying something nice about them, they'd rather say bad about them. So when we sung that song, I kind of like it hit me. I said, I pray that you realize how you talk about people because them words can hurt. Say amen. If you have your Bible, you can go along with me. Romans 4. And then I'm going to go back to Genesis. Ooh, 4. I'm going to start at verse 16. Therefore, it is faith, Romans 4, verse 16, that it may be by grace to the end, the promise might be sure to all the seed, not to that only which is of the Lord, but to that also which is faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all. And as it is written, I made thee a father of many nations before him whom he believed. So you got to believe. Yes. You can want anything you want, but you don't believe. Come on now. With whom ye believe, even God who quickened the dead and called those things which be not as though they were, who against hope believed in hope, that he might become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall thy seed be. Listen, I said it earlier. You stay with God and keep believing God for whatever he promised you. Amen. It's getting ready to happen. It's rough right now. See, we're going through some hard times. Finances, health. Enemy don't try, but no weapon formed against us going to prosper. There's so much, I could stand here and say I'm going through this, going through that, but I refuse to give the devil any place with this because I gave it to God, and I know he's going to work it out. It's already done. Anybody know when you pray, you believe God for it, amen? You don't need to run and tell everybody because you know why? They're going to put some doubt there. Well, how are they going to do that for you? How are you going to get it? It don't matter how God do it, because it's going to be God that's going to do it for you anyway. He may not come the way you're looking for him to come, but just trust him. Believe God. He's getting ready to bless you and your seed. There's a blessing coming in the house. There's a shifting. I heard somebody. There's a shifting coming in the house. Things that was going one way, it's getting ready to shift in your behalf. You better look out and say, you better watch it because I'm getting ready to take off from here now. Something getting ready to happen. That plane take off can't take off faster than what God getting ready to do for you. Look at somebody and say, it's already done. I'm just waiting on the manifestation. I'm waiting on the manifestation. Anybody know that God getting ready to do what he said? Yes. Do you believe him? Abraham believed. He called those things that be not, even though he was 100 years old, Sarah was old, but they still had a child. I know that if God told me I'm finna have a baby, I'd be like, where in the world? How could this thing be? I'd be like, Mary, woo! Now, God, I know ain't nothing impossible. But I'm going to have to ask you, how could this thing be? Lord, help me. It have to be the Holy Ghost. Amen. Okay, and being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body not dead when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. He staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able to also to perform it. See, if God says something, he's going to do it. I say he's going to do it. What have God promised you that he's going to do? Don't come here with this unbelief stuff. Because if you have unbelief, God said, I work with the faith. I work with believing. I got to believe God for some things because I know I don't have it. I believe God for this building. We got it. We had over 20-some years now. A woman can't get a building. I said, oh, yeah, you'll see. God going to give me one. I said, God going to give me one. Well, how you going to get it? I said, I don't know, but God going to do it. I had people running here to see like Sheba had to go see her Solomon, the blessing. I just had to come to see, did you really get it? I said, did I really get it? I said, keep watching. You ain't seen nothing yet. When that $1 million check come in here, then we redo this whole church all over again. Come on now. I said, when we do this church all over again, see, I believe it. I don't know. Y'all don't have to believe it. I believe God going to send a $1 million truck in here. Oh, yeah. I said, I believe it. I said, I believe it. I'm speaking it out. I believe it. He have never failed me yet. Mm-mm. I don't look at where I'm at. I look and see where God taking me. And I call those things that be not, even though they're already here. Say amen. Say amen. I'm going to move on because y'all ain't trying to hear me. Amen. I'm going to keep on. Okay. And being fully persuaded, what he had promised, he was able to also do it, right? He was able to do it. Amen. For us also to whom, now it was not written, verse 20, now it was not written for his sake alone that it was imputed to him, but for us also. See, Abraham ain't the only one going to get some of all this good stuff. I'm going to get some of this too. Listen, look at somebody say, Abraham ain't the only one getting it. I'm going to get some too. Say, I don't know, but I see Abraham. He had faith. If he had faith, he got it. I'm going to have faith. I'm going to believe God. I'm going to get it, too. Say, Abraham ain't getting all this good stuff. No, God. You the same God. Yesterday, today, and forever. You don't change. He don't change. God said he make us a head and not the tail, above and not beneath. God said, I'm getting ready to bless some people in this house. And they don't even know him. He said, that's why you got it rough right now. I'm getting ready to change your name and make you great. Come on now. Ain't nobody going to say, how did she get there? How did it happen? One day somebody came along in the name Jesus. Touched somebody's heart and said, go bless that person. See, God moving on somebody's heart right now to bless you and make your name. Oh, y'all ain't getting it. Y'all don't want this in the name. Y'all don't want. I love when God get to moving. Anybody want? Come on. I want what God got for me. I said, if he doing it for others, he's going to do it for you. As a family, be right with your family. Make love. Care about them. Love them. They don't love you, love them anyway. Don't let nobody stop you from getting your blessings. Don't let nobody stop you from getting what God got for you. It's an assignment of the enemy. He's forming something against you so that you won't believe God going to do it. You can't even talk to everybody about what's going on in your life. Because you're going to have people to say, it'll never be. It can't be. The devil is a liar. Somebody here, you signed for a house, and you didn't hear. God told me to tell you got the house. I said, God told me to tell you got the house. That house is yours right now. I don't know who I'm talking to, but you got to believe. Hakasundo, you got the house. I said, you got the house. Whatever you go for today, you got it. Whatever it is, you got it. Okay, you went and applied for a job, you got the job. Whatever you apply for, you got it. You got to believe God. Today is the day you got to believe God in spite of what it looked like, in spite of which way it's gone. It may go left, but God going to bring it right back in line with him. I say going to bring it back in line. I speak and call those things that be not. Okay. If he did it for Abraham, he's going to do it for Barbara. Put your name there. Put your name there. If he did it for Abraham, Abraham believed, Barbara believed. Ha ha. Look at somebody say, if Abraham believed and he got it, I believe too. And I want you to say, not only I'm being blessed, but every one of my seeds being blessed. No, you got to stand on that word. Every one of my seeds, I don't care if they're out there drugging, I don't care if they're drinking, I don't care what they're sexing, that God going to turn them around because I know his word is true. He's not only going to bless me, but every one of my seeds going to be blessed. Oh, y'all sitting there. Just keep sitting there. Keep looking at your two pennies you got. Keep looking at them two pennies. I said, keep looking at them two pennies. See how far them two pennies going to get you. And keep on doubting. Well, God, don't seem like nothing happening. Well, God, I don't know when it's going to happen. God said, you're looking and your faith is very weak. He said, come on. You have too much unbelief. And it's sad. It's so sad that when you get in a tight spot and your back is against the wall and you know you done did all that you can do. And God said, I'll let you go ahead on and try everything that you could do on your own. He said, now what you gonna do? He said, if you want to come out from that wall, you got to come out that wall and believe me to turn some things around. How many of you know there's a turnaround and there's a shifting in the air? God getting ready to turn everything around to bless you. Because you change. Once you start changing on the inside, once your heart get right, you start changing on the inside, God said, now I'm ready to give you what you asked me for. He said, but I had to get you to a place that you know that God going to do it. And you wouldn't give a man no credit for it, but you're going to give me the glory for it. Come on here, God, come on. God said, if you give me the glory, I'll do anything you ask. You got to know how to lift up your hands and say, God, I thank you. What you going to give me? I don't have it now, but I believe you're going to do it. God said, I will save your home. I'll save your children. Everything you put to me, I'm going to give you. I'm going to give it to you. Every one of your children coming in. Everything that you put your hands to is blessed. You blessed going in. You blessed coming out. You blessed. Come on, somebody need to get happy over here. God said, I'm blessing everything that you can. If it's connected to you, you're blessed. See, can't nothing come near you and don't be blessed. When you come near me, it got to come off on you. I said, it got to come off on you. Anybody hear me? See, I'm not trying to be like this, but it's true. You hang with fleas, you get fleas. You got to hang out with somebody that's going somewhere, got something. And they're living holy and they're living right. Come on now. You just can't hang out with just anybody. But get connected to that vine. If God did it for you, he's going to do it for me. Maybe you just need to we just need to talk about some Jesus around here and let him come on into our house. Come on now. Say, come on in, Holy Spirit. I need you in my house today. I'm talking about this house here. We need him. I read here, it said, Abraham wasn't only blessed for Abraham only, but for all of us. See, it's a song, Abraham blessing his mind. God letting you know that if I did it for Abraham, I'm going to do it for you. Say amen. I look at people that has made it, and I'll be like, if God did it for them, he getting ready to do it. I mean, hey, I got to rub on that. I got to give me some of that, too. See, you hang around poor, you poor. Because all the poor do is talk poor. Po. But when you hang out with rich talk rich. And see, come on, y'all ain't got to sit there, act like you don't know what to talk about. When you hang out with somebody that got something getting ready to happen. But when you hang out with poor folks, all they gonna do, the Bible says you're gonna have the poor with you always. But I gotta give it somebody to rub with them so some of that rubbing can come up. Come on me, come on now. Not that I think it's better than you, but hey, we live in a world where you need. Oh, you talking about money. I'm going to talk about it because I need it. And I can't go say, I'm a child of God. Please don't cut my lights off. I'm a child of God. And knowing I don't believe what I'm saying. Can you keep me with some water? Can you feed me? But when you have faith, and you done sowed them seeds all through your life, something got to come back to you. When you done sowed your seeds and you done did all you know to do, something coming back to you. Y'all don't hear me. I said, when you sow your seed in the ground, something coming back. You sow seeds, something coming back. You come here, get fed, you get so full, they think about money. Let me tell you something. Hold your money. Hold your money. Because when you need a financial breakthrough, you ain't getting it. You ain't get a little dab, do you? But you ain't getting what you need. And when you look around to that person that been giving every time, they've been giving over their 10%. They've been giving extra. They've been giving over here. They've been giving over here. They're giving over there. And when they get to a need, how in the world did they get that kind of money? Because God replies to Elijah's needs back. God said, I give it back to you, baby. I'm going all over myself. I even got this on my note. I noticed God. Because you know what? People want God to do for them. But they don't do for nobody. They don't do what God tells them to do. And that bothers me. I love to give. I love to give. It ain't mine. When I can give, I'm going to give. If I have it, you got it. It ain't mine. Today, I'm so grateful that this day was set apart for family and friends. Because somebody came in here because you was invited. But you came in here because you need to hear this word. You're struggling. You're struggling. And you say, I done did all I know to do. And I give all I have. I even help my neighbors and give something. Always giving out something. But why do you say it happened to me? God said, continue to look up into the hills. Because all your help going to come from him. God getting ready to turn some situation around for you. If you're going through anything and you've been doing what God told you to do, heaven finna fall down here on you today. Look at somebody and say, I know. Because God know what I've been going through with. I've been rubbing two pennies for a while and believing God for change. But it's all over today. Look at somebody says, over today. Not tomorrow, but today. Because the seed I sowed today going to bring my finances in. The seed I sowed today going to bring my finances in. The seed, not yesterday, but the seed I sowed today going to bring my finances in. I sowed a seed. I didn't have it, but I sowed it. I'm like the widow woman. I gave all I had. And you know who saw you? Jesus saw you. He saw you. You gave all. You gave your last. You needed it for something, but you gave it. And God said, because you gave your last, I'm going to show you what I'm getting ready to do. Would y'all believe I'm so far gone, I don't even know where I'm at. God loves family. In John 15:12, this is my commandment. Ye know one another as I have loved you. God is so pleased when we love one another. John 15 reads like this, verse 13. Greater love had no man than this, that a man lay down his life for a friend. Lay down your life for your friend. No greater love. Jesus was the greatest example that we could have. Not many here go and say, I'll take that bullet. Mm-hmm. Yes. I'll take you, chop my head off. Mm-hmm. Getting quiet up in here, I know. Uh-huh. But Jesus went because he had a purpose. Yeah. And then we have the word of audacity to act like we owe something. Mm-hmm. I don't have to do that. I didn't come from that area. Sometimes God will take you out of a place and put you back where you think you don't want to go. But God said, I took you out, but I bring you right back there because you didn't appreciate what I did. See, you don't play with God. That house there, we got here. I let people stay, had nowhere to go, then didn't charge people money, didn't charge anything, didn't do nothing. The last person left out, God said, close the door.
That's right. Amen.
Don't let nobody else in.
Amen.
He said, because you did what I told you.
Yes.
You didn't take no money from them.
Right.
Some stayed a year, two, three, 4 years. You didn't take it. He said, close the door now. He said, because they didn't appreciate what I did. I just used you to have a roof over the head. See, sometimes people don't realize when God's doing something for them. When you got somebody that's helping you along the way. Come on now, y'all didn't hear me. And you take them people for granted. When you take them for granted, it's only God using them to bless you. And you have the audacity to think it's all about you. Come on, somebody. Y'all better hear what I'm trying to say. And you can't even say, thank you. You can't come back and say, thank you. Come on here. Come on. And then you wonder why you're having it so hard. I'll tell you why you're having it hard. Because God said you're going to humble yourself. And you're going to go back. And you're going to have to let people know what they was to you. Can I read? Greater love had no man than this. Lay down his life for his friend. 14. Ye are my friends if he do whatsoever I command you. Listen. Henceforth I call you not a servant. For the servant know not what the Lord doeth. But I have called you friends. Come on. Come on. I said this family friend day. You my friend. You my friend. I said it's good to have friends. Not for so-called friends just to get what they can get out you. But friends, they're going to be there when you need them. Friends, when you land on your back and you can't do nothing. You're talking about come through there and say, let me help you get something to eat. Let me help you. Friends, I call you my friend. Not what his Lord do, but I have called you friend. For all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. See, Jesus tells us what's going on. His servant, he don't, but his friends, he do. You getting to hear God's voice, that means you his friend. But he wants you to do what he tell you. If he tell you to do something, obey him. Because you don't know what he going to do by you obeying him. Can I say something? Ye have not chose me, but I have chosen you. And ordained you that ye should go and bring forth fruit. And that your fruit should remain. That whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, ye may give it to you. Verse 7, these things I command you that ye love, there we go again, love one another. How are you going to be blessed when you don't love? How can you say you love God when you never seen and hate your brothers and sisters that you see every day? How can you do that? How can you love God? Oh, I love God. Oh, yeah. He called me his friend, yeah. But I can't stand him. I can't stand him. Can I say it? We need to examine ourselves. This family friend that we need to examine ourselves. There are people that you carry in your heart that you can't stand, but you want to tell everybody about how you love God. See, when the enemy comes to plant bad seeds in you, he wants you to turn away from those people that you thought loved you. Can I say again?
Yes.
You had people in your life you thought that loved you, but they changed up on you. That don't mean you change on them. The Bible tells us we do good with evil. You don't rail for rail to nobody. You still let God fight those battles. Come on now. You keep on being good and see how God turned it around. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I said, do anybody know what I'm talking about? See, God said, if you're going to be my friend, you got to do it the way I tell you. He said, you got to keep my commandments and do what I tell you. He said, the enemy don't like you because you, he says, over there, John 16. He said, they hate you because they hate me. You know why you got so many people hate you? Because you're representing Jesus. Oh, come on, somebody. I wonder why they so hard on me because I'm representing Jesus. See, when I know, that's when I know I'm on the right track. When the devil's trying to tear me down on every corner, he's trying to bring things against me. That's what made me, I look up and say, God, I'm doing something right for you. See, if the devil on your trail, then you better check yourself. I say, if the devil not on your trail, check yourself, because you must be doing something to please him. Ah! You can sit on them purple chairs and hallelujah, praise the Lord, but if you ain't got your heart right and doing what's right, I know that I know I'm preaching the word of God. I know that I got 3-4 amens, but that's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Thank you, bro. Verse 17, these things I command you that ye love one another. Remember, listen to what it says in 1 Peter 2, 9. Ye are chosen generation. God has chosen you. You're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people that should show forth the praise of him who had called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. God could have left me in my mess. I think about when I was in the world, I used to be a number writer. And some of y'all don't know that y'all too young. But I could memorize the number the minute you give it to me before I wrote it down. And the feds busted in on me. And the guy that I was dating, I was writing, he was working with him. And they took him in the basement and such a mother. I don't know, they didn't find, I don't know where he put them at, but I was up themselves flushing every one of them papers down the toilet. And I know they down there heard that talk, just a flush. Show you how God spared my life. They didn't even come upstairs to search me. Let me tell you, God helped me to escape through some things. God have gave me a way to escape. And I know God did it for me. Because I would not have a record of no jail hood. Ooh, he had his hands on me and I didn't even know it. I said, he had his hand on me and I didn't even know it. I said, God had his hand on you and you didn't even know it. There's some things that the devil had his way with, you wouldn't be here today. Some of you be in prison today. Some of you ain't no telling where you'll be today. But God gave you a way to escape. I said, God gave you a way to escape. Don't act like that you're all cutty. But there's some things you don't even tell nobody. Because if you tell, I said, there's some things you won't even tell nobody. I look at some people, I say, one thing about it, I'm so sorry that you now. I did some of that too, but I didn't. You got caught. I didn't. Don't act like you're so goody-goody, tooty-tooty. Because if the story be told, you better look back and thank God what he did for you. Because you could be in prison or you could be somewhere dead today, but God spared your life. Y'all act like y'all ain't been nowhere. Yeah. Y'all acting that way. Proverbs 18:20. A man that has a friend must show himself friendly. A man that has a friend must show himself friendly. And that is, Lord, my money falling. Oh, that's okay, baby. A man that has a friend must show himself friendly. And there is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. The Living Bible read like that. There are friends who pretend to be friends. But there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. That's Jesus. He'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. He will always, always be there for you. Even when you don't even deserve it. Even when you don't even say thank you. He's still going to turn around and bless you. Romans 4:28, no, I'm not going to read that no more. I got another page to finish. Y'all getting something? Amen. This is when God tested Abraham. Now thy son, thy only son that I told you about, Isaac. I told you, I went ahead of myself. That's okay. He said, stretch over his hand. He took the knife to slay his son. In the 11th verse, and the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. He said, here I am. And the angel said, lay not thy hand upon thy lad, neither do thyself any harm unto him. For now I know that thou fear God. Sometimes, like I said earlier, I'm going to say it again. There are things you're going to go through and you wonder why it's so hard, why you had to go to be the one. I would say, when I got saved, I said to God, my sister, my brother, they all got college degrees, got houses, intercom, they got this, they got that. Why you call one of them to do it? He said, Barbara, shut up. Just like he said, what you got, they gonna need it. He said, just do what I tell you. I had the opportunity to go to Maryland, and I was sitting out on my sister's back patio. A nephew came, he said, Auntie, I got saved. I said, you did? He said, yeah. I said, young man, you gonna preach the gospel? He said, no, I ain't going that way. Today, he's been here several times. Dr. Chiefs, he preached the gospel. Amen. I led my sister to the Lord. I led my brother to the Lord. Amen. God had told me what I had, they needed it. Amen. And it's not a day passed, not one day passed since my mother passed, that my sister won't call me. Amen. She never did before. And I said, what make you call me so much? And I said, it's Mom, Dad. She said, I knew you don't ask me that. She said, but you know why I call you every day? Because you give me the spiritual uplift that I need to make it through my day. You don't know who life you're touching. You don't know who life you're touching. It may not be the word. It may be a kind deed. It may be something you just say, just a word. But you don't know what that word do for a person. Or you show kindness to that person. Come on, people. We live in a world. There's enough crap going on out there now. We in this house. We body of Jesus Christ. We in the church of God. We all children of God. Come on, look at what I say. We all family. I don't have to be your blood sisters and brother, but we are family. God's going to have one day all of us to be together. And while you're living, make sure you get to be his friend. Because you need to know what he wants to tell you. Y'all ain't hearing me. Ain't nobody hearing me. See, he don't call me his servant. He called me his friend. And his friend, he let me know things. Somebody said to me, how you know that? Because he let me know. A good name is rather, Proverbs 21, a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches and love and favor rather than silver and gold. Anytime you walk in a room and the people say, oh, wow, it's something about the presence of God that's on you. You may not see it. You may not understand it. You may not know what they're talking about. But the presence of God will go with you wherever you go. You know what I know? When you walk in a room, that room, I don't care where dark it is, your light on you going to illuminate somebody. It's going to shine. Yep. Thank you, Mother. You got it. The light on you, it's going to change. People say, I don't know why I got to keep looking at her. It's something about that lady. It's something about that man. I don't know what it is. See, because they need that light. You are the light that's shining. Jesus' light shining on you to bring them out of darkness. And you know what? It's good to know people that care for you. Not just a phony baloney. You need somebody that really care for you. They're going to be there when you need them. And they're going to help encourage you. Before they can say something nice, don't say nothing. People's already going through a lot. When they're going through, they don't need you to, oh, that's so bad, this, that. No, if you can't say something nice, don't talk to me. Because I'm going to tell you, okay, thank you, but I don't need that. Right now, I need to hear a word from the Lord. And see, everybody ain't got a word from the Lord because they ain't hearing God. Come on now. And everybody ain't going to be able to say, well, I pray for you. Let's pray right now. Don't wait later to pray for me because tomorrow may be too late. Pray now. If you need a prayer, come on, baby, we're going to pray now. I said, okay, once I leave you, I'll be done for God. Come on, we're going. Yeah, most people know, they call me, I'm going to say, you ready to pray? Come on, let's pray now. Let's get that prayer on now. Because you can't give the devil no place. The Bible said give the devil no place. You give him a place by waiting to see when you want to do it, or when you're going to call. You may not never call and pray with him. Who don't need prayer? We all need prayer. Look at someone say, I'm glad I made it today. To be out here with my family. You know what? God look at us and say, we all his children. We all God's children. I don't care what womb you came from. You still belong to God. We all God's children. Listen to me. I say, we all belong to the Lord. And when that day comes and we go up and make it up into heaven, oh, what a day that going to be. What a day that's going to be. Hallelujah. Praise to the Lord. Girl, I'm telling you, I'm ready to shout right now. Because I'm trying every day to make it in. Look at somebody say, I'm going to make it in. I'm going to make it in. I'm not going to let nobody stop me from getting in there. Nobody going to stop me. I don't care. See, let me tell you something. Read Timothy. The money is changing people. It waxing going back to the world. You don't let, there's nothing wrong with having money, but you don't let money have you. Where are you building your treasure at? Where is it at? And he tells that in Matthew. Wherever your heart is, where your treasure is. Today, I want you to know that. I don't know what God getting ready to do with no one. I don't even know what all he's going to do with me, but I do feel he getting ready to do some shifting in my life. He did not keep me here because I could have died on that table on the 2nd of June. But I couldn't wait to get back in here because I felt like I just want to get in here and do what God helped me to do and praise God. Amen? Amen. Because I know there's work for me to do. There's work for you to do. It's time that you saw, say, God, what's my purpose? I'm here, but what is my purpose? What is my purpose? I want to be right. I want to do something right. I want to please you, God. See, we don't please our stinking flesh enough. Look at me. We don't please our flesh. Think about what you're going to do with someone. Make up your mind. I want to do the things that God helped me to do. If you got a spirit on you that you can draw people, that's God. Some people got spirits on them, they can talk their way out of a paper bag. So God say, let me use that voice to bring glory to me. There's things, some people got some talent, right? Some people can sing, but they really try to make people, they're trying to do all this worldly stuff. Only what you do for Jesus Christ is going to count for eternity. Anybody hear me? Only what you do for Jesus Christ is going to count for eternity. I was a jeweler by trade. Trust me. Nobody know, not one piece of jewelry I made. But I tell you, whoever, the one that know me is the one I might have planted a seed in, said a kind word, did something nice. They'll never forget that when you do that for them. Do something good that they can remember you by. This is I'm talking to family here.
Right.
Who cares about who love you, who don't? You love them anyhow.
Right.
I'm going to say it over again. Don't let nobody cause you to miss out your blessings.
Right.
I need things to make it in this world.
Yes.
And I'm going to get everything I got to get. God going to supply all my needs. Look at somebody and say, God going to supply all my needs too. Because I'm going to do what's right. I'm going to obey him. And to love is pain. When you love is pain. Because the enemy is going to try to break you down to keep you from loving. Love you. Look at somebody and say, I love you. Look to your left, your right, say, I love you. Now that's what I call love. That's what I call love. That man, he didn't only tell you he loved you, he already gave her a big juicy kiss. I saw it. Today, I just want to get your heart stirred up. There is a shift. I feel it. Anybody that's been going through something, I feel that God getting ready to turn it around for you. There's a turnaround. There's something getting ready to turn around. Don't go out there and do something that's going to cause you to miss out on what you got. I might as well go back and do what I used to do because I know how to get the money. Now, don't go that way. Just wait on God. Wait on God. And if you don't know Jesus, this will be the best day that you could get saved today. And if you're backsliding, come around this altar. Let me pray for you. If you need Jesus, come. You hear God brought you here. This is between you and God. God said that he wants to bless you. He has plans for your life. Even out there on live stream, if you're not saved, come and get saved today. Come and give your heart to Christ. Even those that's watching my live stream. And don't let nobody tell you don't need Jesus. The Bible says there's many religions and many false prophets out there. And people don't want you to come any right way. They want you to come any other way you can get it, but not with Jesus. Jesus is the one who died for you. Come on, baby. Come on, there's others. Come on, get saved today. Thank you, baby. Come on. There's others. I'll give you a moment to come on. The devil telling you not to come. Don't listen to him. Come on up here and get saved. And if you're in the backslidden, say, come on up and say, God, I'm going to surrender to you. Please, I pray so much for souls to get saved today. Come on. Don't play with it. Come on. Come on, get saved today. I said, come on, get saved today. We don't know when your last breath is going to leave you. Come on, get saved today. I don't want nobody to die and go to hell. Come on, I'll wait here. I'll wait here for you. Come on and get saved today. Thank you. Thank you. Come on. Come on. I pray for you all. Everybody's getting saved. I pray for you today. You backsliding. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Bless your heart, baby. Come on. 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 I'm going to wait here. I don't care how long it takes because I know the enemy telling you don't need it. You need it. And one day you're going to look up and you're going to see how much you needed it. Come on, come on. I'm going to wait. There's like five more people here that need to come on. Come on. Today is going to make the biggest difference of your life. Today will be the greatest day of your life. There are five people. I know there's five people out there. You're saying, I don't want to go up. I don't want nobody to see me. The day going to come that you're going to have to stand before God for yourself. Don't worry about who see you. You come up here and get saved today. I'll say, you come up and get saved today. I'll say, you get saved today. We live in a real world. The devil want to take you out of here. I'm going to wait for you. Thank you. You can stand right here. I will look directly in your face. God brought you here to me. Thank you. There's more. I'll say there's five. One came. There's four more. Come on, I'm going to wait here. This is the best part of the service. Your soul getting saved. You're going to see it. I was drunk when I got saved. I was so drunk. But God started dealing with me. I couldn't even sleep that night. October the 15th, 1984. And I don't regret it. I'm so grateful. Please don't let nobody tell you. If you sit with someone you know they're not saved, say, I'll walk up there with you. Come. Get a hold of their hand and bring them up. Some people need somebody to come and bring them up. Please, we don't want no one to leave out here without Jesus. No one to leave out here without Jesus. Come on, come on. Come on, I'm going to wait. Come on, baby, that's it. Come on, there's three more. Come over here, baby. Come on. I'm going to wait. There's two people in the back that need to come and get saved. There's one person over here that need to get saved. Come on now. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Jesus wants you. He had this service to come like this so that you be saved. Hallelujah. I'm going to wait for you. These two people, come in the back. Come back in the back. Come up and get saved. Or if you're in a backslidden state, come on up here and give it. God will change you right now. Come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, Kenyatta. Come on, that's it. Come on. Come on. Thank you. Come on, over here, baby. Thank you, thank you. I pray for all your souls. Today I really did. I said, God, you bring these families in. Okay, thank you so much. It's the best gift that you can receive. There's a person over here that's not saved. Maybe it was you, because I know I've felt there's someone over here. Maybe it was you. Thank you. Those that's watching my live stream, please, please, please. Don't let this moment pass you by. When everyone else say this prayer, say it, please, and get saved. Amen? It's just a matter of you asking Jesus to come into your heart. And once he come in, he'll never leave you, never forsake you. You can go to him all time of day or night. He's going to be there for you. He just needs you to call on him. He'll be there. I've called on him for so many things, and he'll turn things around for me. He gave me peace in the midst of storms. I didn't know how I was going to make many times. I didn't know how I was going to make it, but he always made a way for me. He always took care of me. And I'm still 82, soon be 83. I'm still moving on. If he did it for me, he'll do it for you. I'm so grateful that all y'all gave me to give your heart, and those that's in the backslidden state, you're coming back to him. So I want all of you just lift your hands straight up to heaven. Put your hands up to God and say this prayer with me. Say, Father, forgive me for all my sins. Come into my heart. Live in me and help me to live for you. Father, I believe in my heart that your son Jesus, he died, but you rose him from the dead. Father God, I accept your son Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. To serve him all the days of my life. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. As you're saying that prayer, the Holy Ghost came over me. Is someone here going to get really sincere with God? I mean, really. And God going to use you to preach the gospel. I don't know who you are, but you're going to do it. I remember when I had the ministry in the home, and this lady brought this friend of hers to the house, and she got saved. And I said to her, now that you're saved, you're going to preach the gospel one day. And she got angry and never came back. So I had to do a funeral in Elizabeth, and Reverend Wayne was with me. And this lady tapped me on the shoulder coming down the steps. She said, you remember me? I said, no. She said, I got saved in your home. And you said that I would be preaching the gospel. And I want you to know I'm in Jacksonville, Florida, got a church, and I'm preaching the gospel. The same thing that I felt just now, someone here, God going to turn your life around. And you're going to preach the gospel. You're going to preach it. You're going to start, have no desire to be here, do this, things that you've been doing, you ain't going to want to keep doing it. That's what happened to me. Because I felt like the Holy Spirit was living inside of me. And what I did to my body, I was doing it to him. And I didn't want to keep doing that to him. And that's how I got delivered from drinking, smoking, cursing, sex, all that. And I've been free for 38 years. And I had just turned 43 years old. And people say, yeah, you old now, you probably give. But I was young when I started. And I grew old in Jesus. So it's not about your age. It's put into your mind what you're going to do. And then do it. God wants to use you. You got people around you. Get into the word. Read. Let God use you. He will use you. Say amen. Amen. You said that prayer. Young lady, hold your hand up. She has a Bible to give you. She's going to tell you about. I'm going to tell you about. Karen, lift up your hand. God is bringing you whole all the way back right now. Father, I thank you for bringing Karen in here today. She really needs you, God, right now. Y'all pray in spirit. God, I thank you that you have escaped hell door so many times. And you brought her here today that her life would definitely be different as of today, right now. Let her make up her mind and start walking with you. Anything that you put in, any substance that's been in your body, you can't put nothing else in there no more. It's over. It's over right now in the name of Jesus. I say it's over right now in the name of Jesus. You walk out of here, you're a new creature, and you serve God. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. She gonna give you a Bible. I want you to get the Bible and go in the back. No. Just to be closer. Reverend Pam, I want you to y'all stay back there in the back, and she's gonna tell you about your new book. Amen. Reverend Pam, can you touch? They're going to get a Bible from Elder to Matt. And then they're going to go back there. And I want you to tell them about Jesus. Amen. I want everybody, before you go, lift your hand. We're going to be dismissed. Everybody stand. I've enjoyed all of you. I'm happy that you came. I'm so grateful that you came. You made my heart happy. You come visit our house. Come again, please. I appreciate if you come again. Amen.
Just a quick announcement. October the 28th, we will have a youth baptism here at 11 a.m. There's a QR code that you can register your child to get baptized. It's open to all youth. Amen. So if you have any further questions about the baptism, you can see myself, and I'll help answer any question that you may have. Amen? Amen. October the 28th of this month, okay? Amen.
Now say this with me. Say, may the Lord bless you. Lord okay, bless do it like this. Don't just say, but look at someone to bless them. Say, now may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine. And be merciful and gracious unto you all the days of your life. Say, you are blessed and you can't be cursed because Jesus is Lord. And today, I know that God is turning something around for me. I feel the shift in Jesus' name because I know what I've been doing. I've been giving. And I've been caring, compassion in my heart, and doing the will of God. And because I've been obeying him, he's going to restore it back to me. In Jesus' name. You are dismissed. Come again, please. Go in the back. She'll give you a Bible.
Love you, Lord.
Okay, we got cake. Listen to me. There's cake next door. You can get a slice of cake. Celebrating to family, 1 minute, for Family and Friends Day.